Hello, my name is Mike O'Hara, and I'm a physician at Stanford University in the Department of Pediatrics and the Department of Anesthesiology, Perioperative, and Pain Medicine. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to this course on acute stress management. Today and over the next several sessions, we're going to be talking about stress. The healthcare environment exposes us to all kinds of stress. I don't imagine that's news to you. Some of those stressors are pretty universal. Others, not so much. Occasionally, we're exposed to situations that don't just make us stressed, they make us panic. Gunshot wounds, mass casualty incidents, postpartum hemorrhage, can't intubate, can't oxygenate. Perhaps you've encountered them in simulation or heard firsthand about a colleague's experience. These situations can generate significant anxiety, comparable only to a handful of other professions. We call this acute stress, sudden, novel, intense. Acute stress disrupts our primary goal of successfully caring for our patients, and the stakes are literally, and I am using that correctly, life or death. These stressful situations require our immediate attention and response. Existing trainings provide evolving knowledge and treatment paradigms for responding to medical emergencies and highlight the skills necessary to successfully function as a member of a healthcare team. These existing trainings can be effective in improving patient care and resuscitation training. But over time, we've realized that these programs do not explicitly prepare trainees to handle other factors in real life that make it difficult to perform under stress in the moment. This course will address such gaps in existing training paradigms. I've compiled the existing research on stress, performance, and specific acute stress management strategies in an effort to help trainees like you prepare for success under stress. This course is designed to focus specifically on you. You will learn to personalize, rehearse, and employ strategies to manage and improve your performance under stress, and, in turn, the performance of your teams. This can be accomplished in a self-paced manner, because I know you're busy. Now, changing how you respond to intense stress isn't going to be easy. You've learned your responses over an entire lifetime, so the ability to effectively call upon these strategies in a crisis will require a lot of deliberate practice. First, we'll dive a little deeper into our current understanding of stress as a concept. Then later, you'll practice using specific mental tools to improve how you respond to stress in the moment, and work on incorporating these skills into your practice. Whether these intense situations are a frequent occurrence or a rare event in your line of work, and whether you feel comfortable working under stress or dread the idea of it, I'm sure there's something in this course for you. So let's get started on honing your stress management skills to ensure peak performance when your patients need it most.